There are special challenges to shooting documentaries in Afghanistan that are unique to the culture, like attaching a microphone to record a woman's voice. But there are stories everywhere, and a group of filmmakers from across the country are determined to tell them.
There's no place right now as complex as Afghanistan to film, in terms of the gender issues, in terms of the ethnicity issues, and of course, in terms of the insecurity issues. You know, documentary filmmaking is just so hard. And in this context, it's even harder.
But it's changing.
Yeah, exactly.
Michael, an American, is teaching the students the techniques of documentary storytelling, as he has done in other parts of the world, like Pakistan and Bangladesh.
What's going on in the village and what might...
He worked with these Afghan filmmakers 10 hours a day for 5 weeks on camera work, editing, and how to tell a good story with video. Each of the 10 students produced a short documentary that depicts life in Afghan villages with all of the social and economic challenges that their communities face. Hasib Asmaty is a filmmaker from Kabul, living in Badakhshan.
When I tried filming an interview with my friends, I didn't know how to set up a camera in the sun. A friend of mine helped me adjust the camera's iris. When I showed the clip to Michael afterwards, he said, "Wow, what a beautiful picture." Then I was encouraged by Michael's feedback.
Hasibullah's short film is shot in Kabul's Farza district, where there was no school for girls until one woman decided to build one.
خانم وسیما کرکتر اصلی ما که در فیلم بازی کرده همراه شوهرش شوهرش میره
Ms. Wasima, who features in the film, visited villagers' homes and asked shopkeepers and members of the community to let their daughters go to school.
The school for girls is built in an abandoned compound consisting of two tents and a blackboard. Wasima persuades many reluctant villagers to let their daughters attend.
I want to produce documentary films in Afghan villages and districts to reveal people's true stories that are hidden in their hearts. There are a lot of stories that have not been told.
We know this guy's going to keep doing for a little while.
Michael started the training program to teach Afghans to use film as a tool for public engagement and to provoke discussion around critical issues. He says some of the biggest challenges for Afghan filmmakers are winning the trust of the people they are portraying and building close relationships with them. The film also has to be visually compelling.
Afghanistan is still a very oral culture. And people are very used to, I mean, you go into the village, when I've been filming in the village, and they will talk to you for hours. And you can get into really great conversations. But to get, as a camera person or a filmmaker, to get people to understand that now we have to see it. We can't just talk about it. We've got to be able to live it. It can be really, really difficult to get people to practice. You know?
Michael hopes the films produced by the students will also influence perceptions about Afghanistan abroad.
We see the war constantly. We're involved in seeing it through what we're doing, but we very rarely see Afghans doing what they're doing, and we very rarely hear Afghan voices. And that was what was most important to me in terms of working with the filmmakers, for them to present the stories that they wanted to tell, and for people in the West or foreigners to be able to see a whole nother perspective of Afghanistan.
The 10 short films were screened in 20 cities across the U.S. and in Kabul. Philippa Levenberg, VOA News.